you wish to see me?
Yes.
What can I do for you?
Give me back my husband.
What do you mean, your husband?
Oh, you're probably wondering which one.
He's about this tall, blonde hair, wears spectacles. His name is Alfred, and he's your lawyer's manager.
Oh, I have met your husband.
I know you have, so give him back.
How am I supposed to give you back your husband if I've never even had him?
But you just admitted that you knew him.
That scarcely implies that I have met him, and of course I have. He wrote up my last contract, and I think I may have seen him once or twice since then, but that's it. And you said he wore spectacles?
Yeah.
I don't remember him wearing spectacles.
He probably took them off. He wanted to look his best for you because he's in love with you. He never takes them off when I'm around. He doesn't care about what he looks like when I'm around. He doesn't care about me. And I say it again, give him back.
If you weren't such a pathetic young woman, I'd be pissed at you. Where the hell did you get the idea that I stole your husband from
you? I'm disgusted that my husband would pay for flowers for a foul-mouthed wretch like you.
What are you talking about?
I know he sends you flowers all the time.
That's garbage. He's never sent me flowers.
Yes, he does.
Prove it.
I don't need to prove it. The florist told me he charges flowers to his credit card twice a week and has them delivered straight to you. That's a lie. Are you calling me a liar?
I'm not saying anything. I'm just saying someone's lying to you.
Oh, yeah? Well, what about this letter?
Letter?
Yeah. He wrote it to you, and he said,
let me see.
No! I'll read it to you. My darling. Ugh, that makes me want to vomit. Won't be able to make it to your performance tonight. 10,000 apologies. 10 trillion kisses. Ugh.
Oh.
He probably meant to send it to you and forgot it. And then I found it.
Stop crying, you stupid woman.
Why shouldn't I cry? One night, look at you. One night you look like a princess. The next night you're undressing like a Greek goddess. And look at me. I'm no match for someone like you.
This is an interesting case.
What is?
I've never received one flower, one letter, or anything from your husband. And didn't you say you guys haven't been, you know, getting it on recently?
Some of your business?
You used to be affectionate with each other, and now you're not. Am I correct?
Just shut up already!
Darling, this is such a typical case. This happens to us actresses all the time. Your husband is merely just trying to make you jealous.
You really think that's true? Like, this has happened to you before?
This happens to any actress who is moderately famous and attractive. The husband, he tries to make his wife jealous by sending us love letters, flowers, but he's not doing any of that. I used to get really angry when this had happened to me in the past, but now I've realized I've saved many marriages because the wife gets jealous and then she tries to make her marriage work again.
How was I supposed to know?
Don't feel stupid. There's no way you could know.
Wow. I've been such an idiot. I can't believe I fell for that. I can't believe I thought my husband would actually do that to me.
Well, you do look a bit foolish, though, standing there with tears in your eyes, your hair a mess, over what? A short, blonde man with spectacles? No woman should ever have that much affection and love for a stupid man.
Well, now that we've settled that, I'm just gonna head out.
Wait, don't go yet. You have to promise me one thing. Don't ever let him fool you like that again.
Trust me, this will never happen again.
And one more piece of advice. No matter what you find, whether it be a handkerchief, even a woman's underwear, flowers, love letters, don't be caught for a fool again.
Thank you. You're right. I won't. But promise me one thing. You won't tell Alfred I was here, right?
Of course not. I won't say a word.
Well, thank you. I seriously don't know how to thank you.
Now don't start crying now again.
Oh, you made me so happy.
All right, Alfred, you can come in now.